So with introduction to the distributed property, you may have had some experience with this in the past. Different teachers teach it different ways. I try to make sense of it so it doesn't seem like some kind of a magic trick. And so what we're looking at is we have 8, and I'm going to write it differently than they do on Alex because this is how you'll see it most of the time. 8 times 5 plus 9. And they're asking us to rewrite that having used the distributive property. And so your past experience with the distributive property probably goes something like this. Multiply the 8 by the 5, multiply the 8 by the 9. That gives you 40 plus 72. We're not going to do that in this instance. What we're going to do is instead kind of rewrite it a little bit to sort of demonstrate what's really happening here. So what's really going on is we need to put it in Alex here is we're going to have 8 times 5. And then that's going to be added to 8 times 9. And so 8 times 5, 8 times 9 is what's going on with the distributive property here. We're not going to look for an answer even. We're just making sense of what the structure behind this is. And so we have 3 times 1 plus 2. Well, what this really means is 3 times that 1 plus the 3 times that 2. So this is equivalent to 3 times 1 plus 3 times 2. Next, we have 4 times 7 plus 6. And that's equivalent to 4 times 7 plus 4 times 6. And one more here. We have 3 times 8 plus 7. It's equivalent to 3 times 8 plus 3 times 7.